Someone in there, folks.
Hello?
Who's that?
Oh,
it's Darren. What the hell are you doing in here?
Surprise!
Very crazy, folks. Very crazy. You might as well join us then, folks.
Today we are heading to a location that was fortified for many hundreds of years. The first being under the reign of Henry VIII in 1534. Many years later, in 1810, the site was made into a redoubt with 10 guns protecting the nearby port. The guns were upgraded in 1862 as a result of the Royal Commission on the Defence of Great Britain. The battery is once again used in World War I and World War II, with many changes and additions being made. The whole battery was decommissioned in 1956, and to this day lies abandoned and forgotten. In this three-part documentary, we explore the remains of the gun positions and magazines, and see the heavy conversions that were made throughout the decades.
Right, so this is probably one of the 1800 parts to it. Hooks on the wall, isn't it? Over the years, people have parties and all sorts in here.
Oh yeah, so we've still got the door frame.
So maybe old bolts there.
Someone's actually physically taken down the inner part of the the wall.
Got green paint still on that. Oh, whoa, look at this. This is where the shelves used to go up.
Could have a slight L down there.
So that goes up to that battery above us, the gun position. What's this here?
Oh, wow.
It looks like someone's burnt this.
That's a chain, isn't it?
That's another
winch, isn't it?
Yeah. Still got the chain attached to it.
What happened to that? So where?
Look at this. They've gone through the back of the wall.
Yeah,
so you can turn it.
So you've got a paint light. Well, don't wind it up. Might have WD-40.
You know,
can't you?
It's
like a dumb weight or something, isn't it?
That's sad. What has happened that, here?
That's come down from up top. That's part of the boxing in.
Right.
That slipped down, so this would have been sealed in somewhere.
That'd be World War II.
I don't think it would have been.
It's older.
I reckon it's Napoleonic.
Okay.
Hand, bald. Yeah. Well, I might be wrong, you know.
Look at the way it's shaped.
Yeah, that's.
This is like a V. They would have put the shells in there, and it would have slid up in like. This would have been boxed in properly. This is what this is. It's slipped down from up top.
Oh, so you put the shell in and.
Yeah, there obviously would have been an opening here. This is angled to take thing, and there's screws all the way up, so there probably was rubber or something, or leather on the sides to protect it, and that would have
slid them up.
Or there, that's what that is, isn't it? The shells would have sat on there, and it would have just gone up.
Yeah.
and then back round. Every so often, there's probably more of them.
It's crazy.
Them about. So, yeah, unfortunately, that's slipped down from up top. So.
Yeah. So it's just those mechanisms there. And the chain movement then, isn't it?
Yeah, someone pulling it round, so it comes down. It would have obviously sat on there, and as it's come round, pick the shell up and...
It's still got that lever.
Yeah. Yeah. So that would have been, I reckon, all the way up here where all those screws are.
Crazy, isn't it?
So I'll help it slide. But yeah.
That's good. Should we have preserved all this? Not burnt. There's something that's burnt it there.
It's even obviously indented where the shells have been sitting in there at the time.
Yeah.
You see that?
What, the old... Then you got the other hatch underneath. Take you into that room in there. Look at this then, they've got the bloody woodwork still around the, is it the hatch? Would have passed stuff through, maybe shells. Pass the shells through that hatch there, and slide, I suppose the doorway would have slid to stop.
Probably one of the shells.
And the light passages, one light for that side, one light for this side. That's interesting, isn't it?
That's like even hot.
I think there is, yeah, I think they do. But the ventilation don't go up to the surface. I think the ventilation goes off into that room next door. Is that what we found out, Chris, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So
you wouldn't want to come in here with the light.
You wouldn't want the sort of smoke, and you know, if any sparks come up.
Yeah.
You wouldn't want it coming in here. But this hasn't got any holes in it, which makes me think this is not a powder storage.
Well, I've even got cutouts here, but there would have been something here.
Is that a metal frame?
Yeah.
Possibly would have been there.
See, what about shells? Because you think out here, like Darren was saying, you've got these here. Big lump of concrete there, big lump of concrete there. The missing one goes here, that's there.
Right.
Can you reckon there's something on it? What about some sort of rail or something to slide them in?
Yeah.
Store them around there or whatever.
That's interesting. Such a shame it's so derelict. Left. Yeah. But these could have been done.
All this is the bloody wall, isn't it?
Yeah.
Why would they think that there's something behind there?
Oh, yeah. Magazine.
Magazine.
So that's real history there.
Under the smiley face.
Don't even notice that.
Many eyes make light work.
Do you reckon them shelves there would have been passing through that way, or...?
What's that?
Them metal...
Possibly, they might have been there.
I think they're
light passages.
Yeah, so...
That's where that little vent goes, I think, yeah. So it'd go up through... The smoke could go through the...
That glass, that side.
Yeah.
And you'd had, originally, they'd had a light in there. You know, you light it.
Yeah.
It comes out in here.
It's a massive site. Alright, one sec. It's got a fireplace in this one. It's got original wood beam up there. Light fittings up there.
Original floor's gone, isn't it?
Yeah, I bet that was burnt, that. Looks like the one on the Grain Tower.
Yeah.
Look, looks like there was a lean-to or something.
fireplaces are always broken, aren't they, the top parts? Yeah. Have you noticed that? Window frame in place. Yeah, it's a bit weird why they do that. I've seen it in a few places. Oh yeah, look at that. That's not very big, are they?
I'm guessing this is some sort of sink or something there, maybe?
Right.
Because you've got a pipe there. Pipe there. That's not a pipe.
That's
there.
The vine.
Pipe there.
Yeah.
And there's a line that where the roof that. Went.
So it would have been, have some little, sort of, like the hangers there, wouldn't you?
Yeah, that's a, that kind of shelf sink, doesn't it?
Bottoms have gone right through there, though. Looks like it's been kicked through, actually.
So it's a reinforcing bar that they used back then. Like a big mesh rather than... Well, that's
just like EML. That's like I used for glass
screen there.
Yeah.
That's
a bigger version. Oh. It's a rebar. I'm going to wait you come over, eh?
Why?
Because there's brackets on the wall behind the tree for the sink.
Alright, let's have a look then. How did you... Oh, so, right, for the toilet.
No, at the top, the cistern bracket.
Yeah, yeah. Not there.
They push this off somewhere, haven't they? It's come through.
Quite an interesting little spot, though. Right. Much more to see, folks.
All I'd have to do is climb inside it and reenact at the picture of Richard over at Gray.
I wouldn't have been getting in that if it were you...
No.
You not been, have you been over there?
No, I ain't been out. Oh, getting to that one, but they had a few bits.
It's just hanging on a ledge.
Yeah.
If that went, you'd be like...
Dead.
You'd be just... You'd be draping arms and legs.
You'd just have to write that it'll wedge you further down. Yeah.
You see how the level of the floor would have been there?
Yeah. Maybe the hearth might have been raised a bit. I don't know, well, obviously by the time you put the things on here, yeah, it probably would come through the door level.
It's quite interesting.
Yeah, right. This has had a lot of spoil trapped in it, yeah.
See, the years of use of the step was worn away.
Yeah.
Good and hard. Yeah. You see the years of use?
It's worn down.
That's why they ended up doing that, didn't they? Like cutting bits out
of concrete.
Yeah.
Pegs.
The old style wool plugs, and then you've got the shadow in something coming up here on 1, 2, 3.
Oh yeah.
It also goes to show it's been painted a few times.
Mm. It's a truly massive site, this. Really is, actually. It's a lot to cover. Never know, it might be a two-parter.
Crack.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Here.
Got the trees doing it.
Whole wall's leaning.
So they're blast walls, aren't they? I would say. Chris just wants to go straight up there.
There's a thingy there. You can't get the start like this end, you can maybe work quite a lot. Look at your map. It's going to top that one.
It looks like this has possibly been built on an actual gun position. Let's go up then, Chris, let's go.
How do you get up there?
Those steps there.
I'll tell you what, I'll probably reckon the second shaft at more about as deep as that, going up the 2-3 levels.
Right.
At least.
Oh, what, to the second level?
No.
Well, the whole thing?
To the top as well, yeah. All the way down.
Yeah, there's more sign here, but being a round gun position, isn't it? You've got a gun position there, they just built a square building on top.
Yeah, so it's like Citadel Battery, isn't it? It's just a rounded section of the front facing the docks.
Well, here.
That's going to be a serious storm, isn't it?
What the hell was that? Might be a little generator.
I was going to say, it's a fire.
Yeah.
Like a log burn or something, you know?
Right.
So.
Pipes and vent flew out. Yeah. And obviously connecting pipes running.
Still got windows. Glass. Glass. Some sort of generator. Serious amount of screw holes in that wall.
Yeah. Ventilation or drain.
Sounds like it flipped up at some point. Oh, yeah.
Well, if you go first, I think I'll push you when it's stop.
Oh, Jesus.
Should get a nice view up here. Look at the polished handrail.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I do not like heights. I do not like heights. What the hell are you doing, Chris?
Shut the door.
Fucking hell, mate. Give me a heart attack.
This does look a lot like grain, doesn't it?
Grain, yeah.
So that's from downstairs. There could be toilets upstairs or something. Not toilets, but sinks, maybe.
Possibly, yeah.
It could have been a water pump or something.
Light fittings have been removed.
Good, yeah. They're definitely following up from downstairs.
I didn't realise that far. How far around there
you went? Bloody massive, mate.
Well, if you look through the gap...
Goes right down
there. Oh, wow.
That's... a bit of a way.
Well, you guys go first.
No, you go first.
No, because I don't know if people will be behind me. Paranoid. Pushing myself to the limits again here, folks. Just don't look, do you? Just don't look.
They've
always
pushed up.
Oh, yes.
That one
still moves.
Obviously,
would
have been on
a pulley
or
cam
system of some sort.
It's
in a lot of places, but you don't normally still have them.
I think Langdon Battery's observation post has still got the runners and stuff in place.
Would this have been like a searchlight or?
There is something
over
there.
I think
it's easy to work out
where
things are.
Like a rangefinder.
That's it.
So, because. From here, then they would have had a good view straight across and an unimpeded view of basically this whole corner.
The other one over there would go around further.
Yeah, yeah. Like this one could see right down, couldn't it? How the hell would they have, would they have had like a lever on
it? I think they had levers. Have you seen that before, Chris?
What?
Like some sort of lever that you could pull, just pull the shutter shut. I think we saw something.
No, I just hung out the window and laid a ladder.
All right, and then I was at the bottom, wondering if anything was going to fall on my head.
Yeah. Oh, there's another bit of a corner there then.
Yeah, yeah. I think the last time we was here, where that corner part is there, folks, there's a tramp in there, I think. Just to give you a heads up.
The gun emplacements must be original then. And this is second.
I think they're World War II gun emplacements.
Really?
Well, they might have been built on. Is that what you're saying?
I would have said the original bit was older.
The part on the floor?
Yeah.
The sink that's into it. The ground? Oh, yeah, and I think World War II, 1800s.
Yeah.
And World War II, they whacked...
that bit on.
Yeah, the back part.
Because this is built on one of those.
Yeah. So there's a lot of modifications to this this location, folks.
No, it's amazing. Imagine being up here in bad weather.
Quite eerie, actually.
Sort of wondering, you can probably hear it, you can probably feel it sort of moving. High winds.
Makes the best call. Give her a call.
Give her a bell.
Cables and stuff, I assume?
All right. Yeah, that goes right to the bottom, doesn't it?
Whoa.
Chris said he went over.
There's a metal bit. There's more machinery than something.
Yes, I have. Do you want me to get a picture?
Yeah, it's at the road.
That is just well too high, that. So that's a World War II tower. It was built in the Second World War. Bloody hell. There they are. Right at the top. Oh, it goes down to the magazines.
Next week, we carry on exploring the forgotten battery, finding some interesting things in our path.
You are, mate. Apparently one side had a radar sort of stuff, equipment on it, and the other side had a gun on it. And the gap between the two towers was to reduce the vibration affecting the radar. I don't know how true that is, but you know, it's quite remarkable if you see the gap. It goes right up, all the way through. The whole section of these towers is...
Yeah. Might have been abandoned. There's not a lot of information about this tunnel system. But having rifle racks, taking rifles down here, that's got to be something important, isn't it? Yeah, let's see where else we can go. But that's the gem of these tunnels. It's a rifle rack.